That would require to start with the school and, of course, and the family. Yes, and the family, and of course, whoever has learned the Islamic religion has to understand two things: that it has two sides, the worship and the treatment. And of course, if a bird cannot just fly with one wing. Three-year meetings, and there is a synergy between the development and economy, and of course on top of the priority. At the first meeting of the government with the President al-Sisi, that you said that on top of your priorities, just to secure the bread. Through the fiscal of 2014 and 15, the government has decided just to decrease the subsidies and lift the subsidy full on the gas. How could you use the money that's been saved? There's no doubt. Just a small correction that we never decreased the subsidy of the bread. We just manage the system by using the smart card that created create control of the wheat that led the decrease of what has been expanded in the subsidy of the bread. With regard to the gas, there was some sort of gradual lifting of the subsidy, and yet on industries partially, yes. And of course, according to the plan, it's just to remove the subsidy gradually, yet when it is according to our program, and we are working in just removing the subsidies. Alongside, we are working on just establishing an umbrella of the social protection to the marginalized and the poor. What about such a network? It's just to provide a compensation of the social solidarity for those people who have more incomes and the health insurance for those who had no regular income. In the meantime, we made a program deemed TECAFL with respect regarding those people with special needs and adding the job opportunities and interstorming the slums and working the villages of the poor villages and the health services and the schools. In fact, it is an aggressive plan to design such a network to be a protection for the development and the economic reform. I was always saying it's just in a social and economic reform. In the framework of such a social economic reform, we've already paid a concern to the economic reform. What has been done on the level of the legislation to make Egypt an attraction of investment while you are approaching an economic conference? Of course, the economic reform is not just related to the structural reform with respect to the subsidies and lifting or rather tax reform or institutional reform, yet it includes more than that. It's just the optimization of the state resources. In the meantime, it's just to attract investments, and of course there is a gap between the development project including the ability of the government and the development project that require execution, such as creating job opportunities. So that would have nothing but to attracting the investment. And so that would require is just the preparation to have you made this, yes? To create in such an environment through legislative reform that would be issued soon, as well as the investment decree, its vision, which is one that would be the best one throughout the world, because we have a several resources and the investment investment would facilitate and not make difficulties to be clear, to be announced clearly that there is a sort of a real compassion for the corruption and protecting the investors to respect the agreements and to be a facilitation through the one stop windows that would give the investors security. After the break, Egypt at the steps of a new phase of the political aspect through the roadmap to complete the roadmap of the building of establishing the institutions of the state. I'd like to welcome you again. Of such a special interview with His Excellency Mr. Premier, the importance of the date of the parliamentary elections and what are the most significant aspects of to complete such a roadmap. The significance is just to complete the pillar of the state, such as the legislative authorities and the party have already been committed to the first measurement of the roadmap, such as the constitution, and that the whole world have already seen that the great engagement of the people, and followed by the presidential elections, that the president has already made a sweep victory. Yet it was very important to have a good turnout and to have a testimony for the whole world that Egypt is going on the right track to inventing the modern developed state that cannot be made without a parliament. We've already started on 8th of this month to register the candidates. And the government is just doing its role through management, providing the safe environment, logistics, and of course the government does not interfere. Its goal is just to hand over the flag, the torch, and to be fully proud when, God willing, the election to be completed in a safe and security environment, so having a universal testimony that has been done transparently and that the parliamentary be done according to the will of the people. And of course, the role is just a supervision. We would like ask that the constitution and court is just doing accepting the challenge, and if it has been accepted, that would be a chance for the postponement of the elections. Of course, the court and resolution cannot comment. We have to execute it. Just it is premature to say. Of course, the Al-Dastur party, which is one of the biggest ones, what about their impact in such a very decisive phase in executing the roadmap? And of course, we hope that everyone to participate. And of course, the participation of the whole party would give the a sign of the strength. Yet, the parliamentary is ongoing, and we hope that everyone is to participate wherever they want to withdraw. It's up to them and cannot interfere. Some seats have been allocated, such as the youth, the expat, the cops, and the handicapped. That would end the state of marginalization of such a segmentation throughout the parliamentary phases, the prayer one. That should be stipulated in the constitution according to the will of the people, and therefore that would give the inclusivity, just to contain everybody, and it is a policy of the Egyptian constitution to Your Excellency about the women, that has been the electoral law. Israel with 56 seats. In the parliamentary elections in 2011, said that it would give 64. What about the decrease? We said sorry. There are candidates and the people is able to choose and to sneak out in Egypt. We are appreciating the role of the women. And I think that I expected to have a female candidates to be chosen by the people. And now, of course, we would have a great number. Of course, the Egyptian female rules through the revolution was great, and now we have female ministries, ministers, and we have the deputy governors, and schools at the university, and the people is just capable to push the to have the momentum. What else is about to be a candidate, and that would maybe make a state of anger through the people, as it is a figure of the previous regime? What about the steps to be taken of refuse or approve? Yes, we cannot actually interfere, and the people can do this, and they will be more attentive to the past. As I said to you, it is the vision of the people that made two revolutions, know the role, know the path, and of course they will be more attentive to the past, and the people who is capable to selection. Therefore, we may say that you are actually in an equal distance of the whole candidate. We already felt that all the political elites aware that such challenges and entitlements are big, cannot just be based on slogans. It could be a test for the elite to examine such slogans on the social and economic and financial policies and the culture, of course. Whoever is approaching the political life aware of it, and of course they are not aware of the test is the practical participation, and whoever actually is aware of the challenges is just about to be approaching the fire, and whoever is doing or taking such a step should have a vision to in facing such challenges, because it's been chosen by the people to change their lives. And there are clear principles such as bread, dignity, social justice, and they are clear for them. What about the role of the civil society to observe the elections, and how do you monitor the performance? And are they going to be a forum also to monitor? And of course, there is no doubt we welcome such monitoring and supervision as being done in the presidential elections. And there are a great number of international institutions such as the African Union and the EU, and we are welcoming, and we consider it's just like a celebration or a festival, and we welcome them all. After the break, we'll open the file of the foreign relationships between Egypt and the Porto that is actually facing a momentum these days. Just stay tuned. I'd like to welcome you once again, and to continue such a dialogue with Egypt's Premier, His Excellency Engineer Ibrahim Al-Mahdi, and open the file of the foreign relationships and the subject of the leaks that is already occupied the Arab and the Egyptian street, yet has been put in the corner of the attempts of the creating distortion toward Egypt and the Gulf relationships through His Royal Highness King Salman, as well as Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed in the UAE, as Curtin has said that there is a failure attempting to distort or break down the relationship between Egypt and the Gulf countries. What about your comment? And of course, the response of Israel Hines, Salman, as well as Sheikh Zayed, it is just a desperate attempt.